जो यार आपने किन्हों का बोल रहा है, तेरी पार्ट आप दे इलेक्ट्रो केमिस्ट्री। नाउ वी आर टू डिस्कस द सम ऑफ द बेस्ट एग्जांपल्स ओवर टू द दी इलेक्ट्रो केमिस्ट्री। सो टेक एन एग्जांपल ऑन दी फैराडेज लॉ दैट कैलकुलेट द टाइम रिक्वायर्ड टू डिपॉजिट, कैलकुलेट द टाइम रिक्वायर्ड टू डिपॉजिट 1.3 ग्राम ऑफ क्रोमियम व्हेन करंट ऑफ 1.25 एम्पीयर फ्लोज थ्रू ए सॉल्यूशन ऑफ क्रोमियम सल्फेट। सो टेक दैट in the bracket atomic mass of chromium is 52. So repeats once again, calculate the time required to deposit 1.3 gram of chromium when current of 1.25 ampere flows through a solution of chromium sulfate. Atomic mass of chromium is 52. That it is based on the first law of Faraday. The first law of Faraday states that the mass of the substance deposited or liberated at the surface of the electrode is directly proportional to the quantity of electricity passed through in it. So the time taken for deposition of 1.3 gram when you pass 1.25 ampere of current is 96.5. That is a second. That is minutes. So when you calculate the in terms of second, it is sorry. So in terms of second, it is 5,791 seconds. And you divide it by the 60, you will get 96.5 minutes. So usually expressed in terms of seconds. Then take another example. Then a current of 0.2 ampere, a current of 0.2 ampere is passed through a solution of copper sulfate for 10 minutes. For 10 minutes, calculate the mass of copper deposited. Now the equivalent mass of copper is 31. So the same definition and same law is applied. Repeat once again. Example: a current of 0.2 ampere is passed through a solution of copper sulfate for 10 minutes. Calculate the mass of copper deposited, and the equivalent mass of copper is given, that is 31. Here, what are the given quantities? Z is 31. I is how much current is passed? 0.2 ampere. Then how much time it passed? 10 minutes. You can convert into second. So therefore substitute Z is 31. Now the very small amount of the copper is deposited, that is 0.039.48 grams. 0.039.48. Then so take it out. Then take another example. The same way I already solved the first one for Homer. Calculate the time required to liberate 112 cubic centimeter of hydrogen at STP if 5 ampere current flows. It is I want to solve. It is something different. So at STP means 1 gram of the hydrogen gas is liberated, the volume occupied by a gas is 11,200 cubic centimeter. So therefore now we want to first see the number of coulombs required to liberate 112 cc. Here, for 1 grade is 96,500. Now, for how much current for 1 second? Now, we have to calculate the number of coulombs. Number of coulombs of electricity required by 112 cubic centimeter of gas, that is 96,500 into 112 divided by 11,200, because for 1 gram turbulent, it will be 965 coulombs. Then, knowing that, we have to calculate the Q. Q is equal to I into T. So, now I is 5 MPS. Q is already calculated, 965. I is 5 MPS. Time is T. Therefore, T is equal to 965 divided by 5. Now it will be 193 seconds. Means this much amount of time required for collecting 112 cubic centimeter of hydrogen gas. So dear student, so these are some of the best examples over to the first law of Faraday. We have to see the some examples on second law of Faraday tomorrow.